May we all know that nothing ain't cool till you wear the new off the sound of a quarter rolling down the jukebox. Play the Travis Tritt right above the Tupac before you get lost down some road. Slow rolling with the top off the back of a Bronco. Buy a cold sixer with a cashed in lotto. Smiling with her hair blowing out the window. Where you about to go? Yeah, you learn to fly, and if you can't, then you just free fall. Watch a marching band play with the hardest moon coming up. And know that 15 minutes of fame us ain't gonna be what makes us or breaks us, but we'll all be watching the TV the day that it comes. May we all know that nothing ain't cool till you wear the new art. The sound of a quarter rolling down the jukebox. Play the Travis Tritt right above the Tupac. Before you get lost down some road. Slow rolling with the top out the back of a Bronco. Buy a cold sixer with a cash in lotto. She's smiling with her hair blowing out the window. Where you about to go? Yeah, you learn to fly. If you can't, then you just free fall. May we all.
Go ahead and ease over them right now, though. You're fine where you're at. Just nice, easy throttle. There we go. Awesome. I wanted to do that. There we go. Did you see what was happening there already a little bit? As he turned that wheel, that tire was locking, wasn't it? Watch that inside tire here as he does this. That tire locks down. Rear bell side spin. He's gonna make it through here without backing up, isn't he? Maybe. There's a feel you have to get for it. The more you do it, the better you get at it. You want that constant throttle from there. Alright, let's just walk down this way. A lot of forward momentum is always what we're looking for. Well, a little more speed now, just a little more. Got that water pushing out in front of the Bronco, away from the tire. Trail turn assist is still applied. That tire's locked down. Hold right there for me. We never want to use trail turn assist where? Asphalt, concrete, or a very high traction area. It'll break something. Not just a tire, it'll break the vehicle. Too much traction for that much brake buying, so we don't want to do that. Slow down in, absolutely. What's going to happen if we go into that fast? Our suspension's going to compress. When our suspension compresses, what happens, folks? We lose ground clearance.
Absolutely.
All right. Go ahead and bring him on down here, Charles.
What's up, John? The steering wheel's doing this as you drive through there. A little bit on the
top? Don't break it, John.
Don't break it, John. Come this way for the clip a little bit. Back that way, just cut. Hey, walk straight, 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 straight. Small movement. Remember that small movement? All right, hold right there, hold right there, hold. All right, so what happened, folks? He's spinning tires and slinging mud, right?
We need some front differential, right?
Do what?
Add the front differential button.
We could. Is there something else we can do even before that?
That's right, it's way wrong.
How about our stay bar disconnect? Absolutely.
The first button on the dash. First button, press it.
Whoa!
Tires are back on the ground, right?
That's awesome.
Absolutely. So what's going to happen now? He can
that
back.
Was cool.
Use the traction that is available to him for those tires that are now going to the ground and drive forward, right? See what happens?
Awesome.
Come forward a little bit.
That's cool.
Absolutely.
Oh.
Oh. Moving all through there now.
I found myself tricky right here.
See
what
we see
that hole there?
Awesome.
Wow.
You're right. Just a touch.
Like left when we just touch, absolutely. Hold right there. Small movement to that steering wheel. Small movement is not from side to side.
Gotcha.
Quarter turn, eighth of a turn to that steering wheel. So go back that way for me. Just touch. There we are. Now straight forward.
So the difference is if it was differential only, one
wheel. So right there,
turning.
What did we use, folks? Stay bar disconnect to allow us to articulate through that obstacle. It's all we needed to keep tires on the ground, right?
That was awesome.
Come towards me just a touch. There we are. Awesome. Oh, but we're slow. Again, that's why we're so slow. Did we hear that touch, folks?
Yeah.
Think that really hurt anything? No, because we were moving so slowly. Had we come into there at 20 miles an hour and did that? Yeah. It would have bottomed out and probably dented the gas tank. So, that's why that speed's so important. That's awesome. All right. To the right a little more. Come on up. Back to the left, just a touch. Come on forward. Keep going, nice and steady. Just keep moving. Turn that wheel left as hard as you can right now. As hard as you can, and give me some throttle. Just a touch. Just enough to keep moving. Hard as you can left. Tapping, folks. Oh, maybe we should have used one of those gut modes, right?
Sand.
Why did that happen, folks? We got locked in the front. Can we lock the rear right now?
Yeah.
Nope. Because we're in tail turn assist.
Oh.
This is a wonderful learning moment of what happens when we don't fully understand what we need to be doing. Because what should she have done through there? What would have been different?
Sand mode lock.
Sand mode, front locker possibly. What if we just maintained a little bit more throttle? When we felt that vehicle starting to dig down, we needed to let off of that throttle just a little bit to lighten up a little bit. So there's multiple things, and it's just a learning process. She's never driven the Bronco. I don't fault her one bit for this. It's just learning that process of what you do. So, can we get out of here? Is it gonna get out? What happens if we just turn that wheel back to the right and straighten up a little bit? Turn that wheel to the right for me. Oh, okay, the wheel's straight for me. Give me just a touch of throttle right now. Are we going to drive up out of this?
Can we go sand now?
Hold on. Let's try something.
I got to know.
So, as soon as you stopped, or as soon as you started spinning there, you stopped. Let's give it just a touch more throttle and see if she'll pull out of there.
Nice and gently, stay with it. Nice and gently, turn that wheel left and right, just a touch. See how easy that is, folks? It's not always about the technology. It's driving techniques that make a big difference. She did no technology extra there to get out of that. She'd buried that to the axles. All she did was apply light throttle, turning that steering wheel back and forth through there, pulled the Bronco up out of that hole. Now, could we have just gone into sand mode and probably done that for us? Absolutely. But we want to teach that proper technique.
That's wet sand too.
It is wet sand. It's different than dry sand. You're absolutely right. You are completely right. Our sand is very wet.
I know.
That sand is actually... Give me some throttle. Give me some throttle. Give me some throttle. There we go. There we go. Stay on it. Stay on it. Stay on it.
Right there for me. That's perfect. Nice little donut boat there, right? Everybody knows how to do that now. It'll be a lot of fun in your Broncos. I promise you. Every Sunday I see people filing in through those front doors. Gotta cross up on that steeple. Yeah, it's time to praise the Lord. Some watch it on their TV. Sitting on the couch, me, I get in my old Bronco and point those headlights south. Oh, ain't got too many miles to go to save my soul. Yeah, I go down and sink my feet in the water and I soak up that sun and I watch it set. Yeah, I can feel the power of the saltwater gospel.
There's an owner's manual on here talking to me right now. With a video! With an explanation! Bronco's awesome.
Yeah, it looks a little... Oh, yeah. Oh, that's bad.
Painful.
Ouch, yeah. Just saying.
Yep,
differential. Oh, he's doing it. Yeah. Oh, yeah, look at that. In action. Oh. You know what? I like adding the modes as you need them. You know what I mean? Makes sense.
Yeah. Yeah, only when, because if you would have had it on there.
Just touch. There it is. Perfect. Nice. Good job. All right.
So you're behind me? Are you driving behind me?
Yeah. Yeah, we're right behind you.
That's perfect. I love it. You done this before? Yeah. Good job. All right, once we hit the bottom down here, go back into that drive and just go around to the left there.
close he got to rolling his Bronco over that hill because he wasn't following hand signals. Real close. When I'm pointing, we got to be doing that. Take off a little bit right there, folks. What's happening? Why is he accelerating a little bit right there?
It just seems like it's slipping on the rock.
Absolutely, we lose traction. If I do not have traction, none of my systems are going to work for me, right? So I'm always looking for that traction. That trail control has to have traction for it to work. As soon as it loses that traction, you speed up. But as soon as you get that traction back, slow back down, and it keeps those tires moving. Look at it this way, we've got folks. One thing, if you were to put your foot on the brake right then to slow yourself coming down that hill, what happens?
Slide.
All four tires apply brake and slow you down, or you slide. The vehicle can do what? As it's coming down that hill, it is monitoring each wheel speed sensor, so it can apply brake in one position on one tire and not on the other tire as it goes down through there, as it can see that. So it could pick one tire on the right front and a left rear that has traction and apply brake on that, where it can see the other sped up. It's going to loosen that brake up a little bit, forcing more pressure to those other tires that have traction. That's why it works so well through there. We can't do that. I can't take my foot off of one pedal and make it press four different ones in the car to affect those brakes, right? Technology is amazing as long as we know and understand what it's doing for us as we're going through there, right? Anybody have any questions on that?
Steady on that throttle. No one control.
Corey, you're offline a little bit for this.
Well, we're going on this side. Perfect. Nice and steady coming off of there. I love it. Man, I'm going to be teaching this class by the time you're done. Come on down. Nice and steady as we come off this. That way, just a touch. Nice. That's perfect. Absolutely. Love it. Good job. Nice and steady. There we go. Man, that is close. That's perfect, yep. Just a touch, there we go. Love it. That's perfect, good job. Nice driving down through there. Good control, nice braking, and keeping us moving forward, constant momentum there. Good job, John.
To the end of that, if you want to switch drivers, if your other passenger is of legal age, feel free to go ahead and swap drivers and let them drive.
I'm in Baja mode. Let's do this. As soon as that guy makes his left turn, I'm going full throttle, baby.
There's a place I know about where the dirt road runs out. We can try out the four-wheel drive. Now what do you say, girl? I can hardly wait to get a little mud on the tires. 'Cause it's a good night to be out there soaking up the night. Stay out a little piece of shoreline. I've got the perfect place in. We'll be right back. get there, you gotta get a little mud on the tires.
Absolutely. And just like you, I can't jump either, so I got to slow down through here just a little bit. Back through here, up on that high banking.
Yeah.
Cross our whoops.
Woo-hoo.
Put a brake at that rear slide. Get a set up for that dip. Back out for that final drive around this corner.
Yeah. The slides are where it's at. I like the sliding.
Ooh, sounds like we just popped a tire.
Uh-oh.
No, James. Maybe not. Just something else popping. Awesome. Nice.
That was awesome. Good. High five.
Awesome. Control of that steering wheel. We're going to be doing a little bit faster than you guys were, but...
That's the best part.
Using that berm to help me through here. We're always thinking about that as we're going through there, right? Absolutely. Using that berm again on that throttled uphill. What do you notice, guys, what I've been doing the whole time? Still shuffle steering, right? I ain't blowing my horn yet. Another big dip. We're going to slow down for that just a touch here. Come up out of here, back on that throttle. Let's see what happens here. We are in Baja mode. Turn sideways a little as we go through the dip. Lining it up, I love it. Round the bumps, and just like you guys, I can't jump it either. Lawyers, right? All right. Over here, up on the high bank curve.
A super successful, awesome couple days at the Austin, Texas Ford Off-Rodeo Experience, and I cannot wait to get my Bronco.